right of Indigenous people to use, develop, revitalize, and transmit their languages to future generations is a key component of the United Nations Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples. Where the internet may be especially effective is in involving younger generations in language preservation and revitalization, which is crucial for the long-term survival of Indigenous language and culture. With the advent of more affordable and accessible hardware and more widespread internet connectivity, increasing numbers of Indigenous people of all ages are accessing information online. They rarely do so, however, in their native languages. There is a movement within Indigenous communities across Latin America to express themselves online and also to create and distribute digital content in their native languages. Many of these initiatives are led by young people who act as bridges to the wider community, motivated by a desire to see their languages and cultures represented online. These digital activists generally work without compensation or widespread recognition. Their reward is knowing that by increasing the presence of their languages and cultures on the internet, they're preserving their Indigenous heritage, as well as laying the foundation for future generations to communicate more easily online. Together with many local partners, Global Voices has been providing support by bringing these young people together through the creation of a network of Indigenous language digital activism in Latin America. Some digital activists use blogs to express themselves in their native languages. Before 2004, having your own website meant knowing computer code or owning a server to host content. With the arrival of free platforms such as WordPress, Blogger, Tumblr, anyone with basic computer skills is now able to set up their own website and publish their content in a matter of minutes. Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram are among the more popular social media platforms where people are interacting in their native languages. For languages with a stronger oral than written tradition, podcasts, self-contained audio programs distributed online, are an easy way to capture and showcase the beauty of a culture's words and music. One doesn't need expensive recording equipment or a studio, but with a laptop, microphone, and free software, anyone can record, edit, and share sounds. Another tool being used by language activists is video. Here, again, costly equipment is no longer a requirement. You can easily produce short films or stop-motion animation for online distribution using a webcam or mobile phone and share them on sites such as YouTube or Vimeo. Wikipedia, the free, user-edited online encyclopedia that prides itself on compiling the sum of all human knowledge, is another area where Indigenous language activists are slowly gaining ground. Underlying much of this activity have been the free and open source software movements, wherein developer communities make software code available for free and allow others to adapt and build upon their work. This has made it possible for speakers of various languages, including Indigenous languages, to translate or localize software interfaces into the language spoken in their communities. Many digital language activists, however, still work in relative isolation and face an array of challenges. There is a lack of connectedness on local, national, and regional levels. They may also face technical challenges such as a lack of keyboards or Unicode fonts to type the characters used in their languages. Many languages communities also lack consensus on the formal written version of their languages. The good news is that Indigenous language initiatives have been finding solutions to address these challenges by forming partnerships and finding innovative strategies. Helping language activists forge connections among themselves is the idea behind a series of Indigenous language digital activism gatherings that Rising Voices has been co-organizing since 2014. The first was held in Oaxaca, Mexico in October 2014, followed by events in Bogota, Colombia in June 2015, and in Cusco, Peru in December 2015. These gatherings provide a space for digital activists to share personal experiences, teach one another through skills-building workshop, and most importantly, building networks for peer learning and knowledge exchange that will continue when participants return to their home communities. These gatherings have resulted in the creation of a web portal called Activismo Lenguas that highlights examples of digital activism in Latin America, categorized on an interactive map by country, language, and digital tool. Language activists can use the portal to connect with like-minded individuals and groups. While the internet won't magically solve the problem of language loss in Indigenous communities in Latin America, it can be an essential element in an overall strategy that involves academics, non-governmental organizations, grassroots groups, and policymakers. The Indigenous Language Digital Activism Network is playing a role in inspiring and teaching other communities throughout the region in the hope of ensuring that their language is well represented online and can endure for future generations.